Using census data, and a number of countries have been doing it, and I think it would be very useful to see whether what we are doing, the programs, are effective, and are we using the money wisely. So, what are the public health benefits of direct investment in infections? So, as I mentioned, the first thing is, of course, the rate of new infection, which allows you to help with incidence. And also, if we can identify the risk factors, what are the risk factors that cause people to get infected in the first place? And where are the hotspots? So you can target your prevention effort and resources to those particular locations or the particular populations. You also can assess the impact of prevention effort. If you are spending a lot of money preventing, trying to prevent the infections, you really want to see is it really succeeding? And you have multiple rounds of incidence assessments. You actually can assess whether the incidence is going down. You can also monitor the emerging subtypes of viruses by looking at or subtyping the population that is newly transmitted or newly infected population. And the same way, you can actually look at the transmission of drug-resistant viruses, which is very critical as you respond to treatment in the country. And there are individual benefits as well. Early diagnosis of an individual, of course, allows for better prognosis and a better outcome. You can actually provide them very targeted risk reduction counseling and hopefully a behavior change which will result in a prevention of transmission. Hopefully they will not take virus. The early treatment also can be used for prevention of transmission because the recent guidance, and especially in Western countries, people are thinking of test and treat. So put the people on early treatment irrespective of serious outcomes. And again, even WHO guidance has gradually gone up in terms of their qualification for treatment. Right now it's 500 and below. But many countries are beginning to treat people very quickly before the reservoir, virus reservoir is established. So what are the methods for incidence estimation or contamination? One of the most common and easy in terms of thinking is the prospective follow of negative people, where you can actually have a large number of people who are negative and you follow them over time and you can actually follow them, let's see, you actually follow about 10,000 people over a period of 1 year, and at the end of the 1 year you come down how many are infected and you can actually determine the incidence. However, that is very expensive and logistically is very difficult. Number of people have done that in the absence of any methodology, and we have done it ourselves, but there are a lot of challenges apart from the fact that it's very expensive. The recruitment bias, the people who recruit in the follow-up may be different than those who do not recruit, and there is also loss to follow-up.